Well, ladies and gentlemen, apparently my performance in There Will Be Blood made me the plastic fire-helmeted talk of the town. Because I was soon tapped for another filmic outing. This was in the Steven Soderbergh film, The Informant! I did not yell that for applause. I yelled it because there's an exclamation mark at the end. Now, I get a call that I have an audition for a Steven Soderbergh film, and my agent's office actually used the word film. And I think, well, this is a big deal. I am a real actor now. And I'm very excited, very full of myself. And I go to this audition thinking, I guess I really got the goods. I don't know Steven Soderbergh. He's not some guy that hangs out at a nightclub. This means this is for real. It's legit. And I get there, and then I see all of these other stand-up comedians that I know. And something is not right about this. I see people, and I know I'm a better actor than that idiot. So I say to one of the guys, and I try to keep all the tension out of my jaw as I ask him, what are you doing here? He says, oh, well, you know, it's based on a true story, and the story is so crazy. The director is doing this sort of subtext thing just for fun where he's filling out all the supporting roles with people from comedy, stand-up comedians and stuff like that. And I think, oh, that sounds like fun. I thought I was a real person with real talents. Turns out I'm just a freak. Like there might as well have been an ad in the paper. Send me all your weirdos. People with two glass eyes, feet for hands, just the weirder the better. Doesn't matter if they can act a lick. So I am cast as an FBI agent opposite the actor Matt Damon, who is playing an insane person. Scene is very brief. I'm once again responsible for three sentences. This is about all I can handle film-wise. So I am seated opposite Matt Damon at this table, and something strange happened while I was sitting there. Matt Damon is between takes. He's telling a story. As he's telling the story, an assistant comes over to Matt Damon and places in front of him this bowl, this clear bowl that contains this bright blue liquid. And floating in the bright blue liquid in this clear bowl is a smaller clear bowl. And in that smaller clear bowl are these two opaque gelatinous cubes. So while Matt Damon is telling this story, he very calmly takes these opaque gelatinous cubes and he pops them in his mouth and he continues talking. And everyone else around the table is acting like, this isn't crazy! I'm on the other side of this table. I am losing my mind. What were those cubes? Do they all eat cubes too? Are they gonna make me eat cubes? A year goes by. I am telling this story on stage at the Vancouver Comedy Festival. I get to the part about the cubes. From the back of the room, I hear a voice say, I know what those cubes are. And I say, who said that? And the voice says, it's me, Tom Arnold. Well, of course it is. What took you so long, Tom Arnold? So I say to him, Tom Arnold, what were those cubes? Tom Arnold asked me, was it towards the end of filming? I said, yes, it was, Tom Arnold. I distinctly remember them saying this was the final week of filming. Why? Tom Arnold said, well, he gained weight for the role, and as the filming was winding down, he was beginning the weight loss process, and those cubes are part of a cleanse. And I said, Tom Arnold, you have done it, meaning you have cracked the case. Tom Arnold says, clearly I haven't done it. Tom Arnold, that's not what I meant, and you know it. Now, folks, you can imagine my relief, because for the better part of a year, I was laboring under the misapprehension that Matt Damon was an extraterrestrial. I thought he had crash-landed on our planet. He was pretty good at our Earth pretending. He decided to make a go of it. Hey, guys, I will stick around on your world and win trophies for you, but... Two things. One, I do need some gelatinous cubes to breathe your atmosphere. And one diva move, since I'm a star, could you put them in some blue liquid? Thank you.